Hi everyone, and welcome back to A Writing Guy. Now, let's talk about something that has been popping up a lot lately, ADHD. It feels like everyone either has it, thinks they have it, or knows someone who has it. ADHD, or Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder, used to be something we mainly heard about with kids, but now more and more adults are being diagnosed too. So, what's going on? Is it a legit increase in ADHD cases, or is there something else driving these numbers? In this sort of academic episode, we're going to explore why ADHD diagnoses have been skyrocketing. I'll dig into the genetics, modern life pressures, and the impact of our tech-driven culture. Plus, we'll look at solutions to help those living with ADHD manage their symptoms and offer some ways that we can curb over-diagnosis. And disclaimer, I am not a psychologist. I'm a teacher who has been focusing on young learners and who did his homework on this topic. I'm open to feedback and constructive criticism in the comments. So feel free to chime in with your thoughts. And the full article with references and links will be in the pinned comment section down below. And if you would like to read more, please head over to awritingguy.com. Speaking of which, if you are looking for writing instruments reviews, articles like this, or writing goods, please check out awritingguy.com. It's my personal website. And I have been trying to turn it into some sort of full-time business. So if you're interested and if you would like to support the channel, please check out the links in the descriptions as well as the Patreon. Or if you would like to support me directly, all of the info is available in the description. Now, let's get back to the topic. What is ADHD anyway? Now, it is a neurodevelopmental disorder, which means it's something that starts in childhood and affects how the brain works over time. The main symptoms are inattention, trouble focusing, organizing tasks, or following through with things, hyperactivity, restlessness over the need to move around constantly, and impulsivity, acting without thinking, like interrupting or making decisions too quickly. ADHD has been recognized over a century, but it's not that the disorder itself is new. What's changing is how we're diagnosing it. Since the criteria for ADHD in the DSM-5, the manual that professionals use for diagnosing mental disorders, got updated in 2013, there's been a big jump in diagnosis, especially among adults. So, the roles of genetics in ADHD, it's highly genetics, according to research. In fact, if your mom or dad has it, there's a good chance you might too. It's estimated that ADHD is around 74% heritable. This means the DNA you inherit plays a big role in whether you'll develop ADHD. But if genetics have stayed over the same over time, why does it seem like more people have ADHD now than in the past? People have ADHD have lower levels of dopamine, a chemical in the brain that helps with attention and motivation. Modern brain imaging technology has shown that certain parts of the brain responsible for focus and decision making might develop differently in people with ADHD. And here's the kicker. There are a lot more reasons as well as social factor that involves in the big jump in the numbers of cases and diagnosis. The first thing is the digital overload. The way we live our lives now might be making ADHD-like symptoms worse. With smartphones, social media, and constant notification, we're being pulled in a million directions every day. studies show that our attention span are shrinking. In 2000, the average attention span was 12 seconds, but in 2015, it has dropped to about 8 seconds, shorter than a goldfish. The flood of information makes it harder for everyone to focus, and it might explain why more people think they have ADHD or end up getting diagnosed. It's not just adults feeling the heat. Kids today are dealing with school environments that requires them to sit still for long periods with little flexibility in how they learn. When kids can't focus or stay still, ADHD is one of the first things that gets looked at. But is it always ADHD, or could it be that the school system is not adapting to different learning style? And a more administrative reason why we have more ADHD cases is the expanding in the ADHD criteria. Now, the latest version of the DSM expanded ADHD to include adults, and it allows for more flexibility in how symptoms show up. More flexible criteria means more people might have gone undiagnosed before and now are being recognized as having ADHD, which isn't necessarily a bad thing, but it's part of why the number have jumped. Is it being overdiagnosed? Now, it's great that we're getting better at identifying ADHD. There's also a downside to the surge in diagnosis. Some experts believe that we're over-diagnosing it, especially in cases where some might just have trouble focusing or in a hyper-stimulating environment or feel stressed out. ADHD medication like Adderall and Ritalin are well known, but they work wonders for people who genuinely need them. But with the increase in diagnosis, there's a growing concern that some people might getting misdiagnosed and prescribed these powerful medicine when they might not need them. This has especially become a problem on college campuses, where meds are sometimes used as study drugs by students without ADHD. For some people, getting an ADHD diagnosis can feel like a relief. It gives a name to the struggles they've been dealing with for years. But for others, there's a risk of over-identifying with the diagnosis, which can limit how they view their potential and capability. So it's important to remember that ADHD is just one part of who someone is, and not the whole picture. So what can we do about it? Now, how can we better manage ADHD both on an individual and societal level? First, it's crucial to raise awareness about what it is and what it isn't. We need to make sure that teachers, parents, and guardians understand the full spectrum of symptoms and what to look for. And sometimes kids are just being kids, energetic and curious. And they don't need a label slapped on them. Adults too, they may be struggling with focus for reasons unrelated to ADHD. Now, behavioral interventions like CBT have been shown to help people manage their ADHD a bit better. It helps them recognize patterns, learn coping strategies, and developing skills and time management. And sometimes these can be just as effective as medication. Start with non-drugs treatments when possible can prevent over-medication and give people the tool they need to function in everyday life. Another thing is to reduce screen time, especially for kids. In the meantime, increased physical activity can help manage ADHD symptoms. A lot of studies show that spending too much time on devices can worsen your focus issues and even contribute to hyperactivity. Encouraging more exercising, outdoor play, and physical movement and hands-on activity can give kids and adults a much needed break from the screen and help their brains reset. Whether in school or in the workplace, we need to create environments that support different learning and working styles. For school, that might be incorporating more movement breaks, offering different types of lessons, and doing other things. For adults in the workplace, it might involve flexible work hours, options to work from home, or using tools like project management, etc. Now, because this is a fountain pen channel, I would suggest mindfulness practices like meditation or writing journals to train your focus for a longer period of time have shown promise in helping people with ADHD manage their symptoms. Regular mindfulness exercises can help focus and reduce impulsivity. It's a pretty low-cost, low-risk strategy that anyone can try out, whether or not they have ADHD. And finally, in the conclusion, why are we getting diagnosed with ADHD a bit more? There are a lot of factors involved, and if you would like to check out the references as well as the research to back it up, please check it out over awritingguy.com. I'll link the article in the comment section below. And again, to better address ADHD, we need a holistic approach. It's not just about getting people on medication. It's not always the case. It should be tackled on many different factors and many different perspectives. So if you guys find this video essay a bit helpful, thank you. Like and share the video. And if you're interested in learning more, please check out writingguy.com for more writing instruments reviews, articles like these, and writing goods. Again, there are gift codes. And thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.